Inflammatory myofibroblastic tumours of the bladder typically occur in females between the ages of 10 and 40. The size varies between 1.5 to 13 centimetres. They may recur following surgery, but they are benign tumours and they do not metastasise. And here is a low power view of an inflammatory myofibroblastic tumour of the bladder. Presentation includes hematuria, urinary obstructive symptoms, pain, mass, and occasionally there may be fever and weight loss. The gross appearance of an inflammatory myofibroblastic tumour of the bladder is usually a submucosal nodule or polypoid mass. Histologically, they are composed of spindle cells, occasional mitotic figures, but these are normal. The background is in areas myxoid, and a fairly characteristic feature is a patchy lymphoplasmacytic infiltrate. A useful diagnostic feature is that the majority of inflammatory myofibroblastic tumours are positive for ALK1. ALK stands for anaplastic lymphoma kinase. Here you can see the typical features of an IMT. There are spindle cells lying in a myxoid stroma, and then as we scan along, you can see the lymphoplasmacytic inflammatory infiltrate. In addition, there is a component of neutrophil and eosinophil polymorphs with some extravasated red blood cells, and these are all features that can be seen in IMTs. This is the AE1-AE3 stain for cytokeratin. You can see that the urothelium shows strong positivity with insignificant staining of spindle cells. Some IMTs, however, do show strong staining of spindle cells for cytokeratin, and this can be a catch where the spindle cells may be misinterpreted as a sarcomatoid component of a urothelial carcinoma. But here is the ALK1 stain, and this shows strong positivity of the spindle cells, clinching the diagnosis of an inflammatory myofibroblastic tumour.